What we did here is a corn sheller. We put three nails in. We can put four, because there's a hole right here. And you just put it in there. Shells it.
Hey, good afternoon, guys. I'm just getting ready to rake some corn fodder up here in the feedlot. We got a 2112 H&S action rake and the John Deere 7290R. Got nice drying weather today, so let's go ahead and rake some up and see what it looks like. I usually start raking in the middle and then do the end rows last. Rake does a very nice job of raking corn stalks and grass hay. We just got done raking grass hay. So I'm going to make a couple rounds and I'll come back to you here in a little bit. Okay, this will be the first corn fodder job of the year. I'll tell you what, if you're looking at a rake, I know there's some guys that own Frontiers and a couple other different ones, but for a nice small farm operation rake, these H&S rakes do a nice job. Lined up here a little better. So we're going to get the baler ready next. Now I have some grass hay laying too, so depends what gets ready here. I want to make a couple bales of corn fodder and then finish up with grass to clean them out. So when you don't have it sitting in the baler too long. It doesn't take long to rake up corn fodder with this rake. We're just playing with this rake with this tractor. Alright guys, we're going to go out here and try some corn fodder just to see what the moisture is. Do a couple bales. And then walk around here. We did go ahead and service the baler. The tractor's ready to go. So, hang on.
out baling some of the corn fodder, as you can see. The farmer's son has the 330G out here. He's picking out up some of the bales and bringing them in. It's a gorgeous afternoon. The fodder's about 18%, but good enough. Sure is flying.
Well, you can definitely say I'm a big supporter of John Deere. We'll wait till the skid loader gets up here yet, but definitely does a nice job making the bales with packed in their tank. Okay, there's all the stuff there we just for baling and a little bit of our camera crew there. It takes a lot to put a video together sometimes, but hope you enjoyed it. Well, you can see I'm a big supporter of John Deere. Hope everybody's enjoying their Saturday. Takes a lot to make a video for you guys, so I hope you enjoy it. We're sharing what the John Deere L341 Big Baler is doing here in corn fodder. 7290R, 590M Gator, and the John Deere 330G skid loader. Hope everybody enjoys the day, like I said, and let's see what else we get ourselves into. We do have some grass hay, so that's the next here, so. Talk to you later. Well, you can see we're back in the corn fodder here. Just trying to get everything set up. Be the very first corn fodder job for this baler for 2020. And the last job for 2020 on the grass hay. So we are running on the ratio 1:1. How that handles here in a minute. Let's see the camera that bales coming off. You can hardly see the windrows, but they're there. So I'm going to push a little harder here. We want to run at 6 mile an hour. I want to get up to about 8 or 9. I think it feeds in a little better. Might stop and see it. I did not take the wedges out. There's wedges in there. They recommend taking out for corn fodder. Their bale came off, so. So we have two grass bales in this field and corn fodder. I want to finish up with some of the drier grass, but it was one of the bales he's just picked up there in the skid loader that was just baled here this afternoon. It looks really nice. So a couple of green spots in it. It's kind of expected for this time of year. bale corn fodder. It's saying 17. So this is dry enough for being used here right away. Yeah, it's kind of hard to see the window. There's quite a bit there, just tie another bale. Now this year I started out and packed the knotters up with some grease there and stuff, and just getting cleaned up before I went to corn fodder. Now we're running this John Deere twine in here. Well, that's a nice packed in bale. I don't know what they weigh or anything. We'll have to weigh some, I guess. Here's some of this grass hay we got done earlier. Goes the first bale. And again, we're at 18. Moisture there. Just need some spots to clean up some manure here, so that's why I'm baling it today. Otherwise, it would just be left here for a couple more days when it's like nice weather. Thank you. 5. Seven and a half foot bales. I didn't measure them yet. I think that's why I sat there on grass. Alright guys, well, we got done with that corn fodder. We're going to head down here and got three more strips of this grass head to clean up. Another gorgeous fall day. Okay, back in this grass. I did not blow the baler off like I wanted to. I decided to bale this stuff because I'm really busy here with corn harvest here next week. We'll have a lot of things going on, and I just thought, well, overall, you would say this is really nice grass hay, but I pretty much wrote it off as mulch hay or just some grind it up and feeder cow hay or something. I don't know. 15.9 moisture. There's some other green spots, and yeah, we could put acid on it, but there again, I don't know. It's amazing how fast this stuff gets dirty when you do a little bit of corn fodder. I was going to do some soybean fodder too. I'm not sure if we'll get that done. We'll have some ground that, it's going to have to be turbo-tilled before we plant it, or raked up and baled the fodder off to get the drill to cut into a little bit better job. Corn fodder bales down with us. We're still in the baler. He's getting the bales in here. He's keeping the corn fodder separate and the hay separate, so he's doing a pretty good job.